Hello friends, I'm Sheetal and you are welcome back to Target Study YouTube channel. Today, first of all, I would like to thank you all for supporting by watching and appreciating our videos. I would like to ensure you that we will keep working hard to upload meaningful videos in future too. Keeping our promise in mind, today also I'm here with a video about one such medical profession which is very high in demand in present times. You must have seen a video on neurologist. Some of you asked about the details of a related professional known as neurosurgeon. Even there were some doubts about the two professionals. We will definitely upload a video to clear your doubts about the difference in the two. In this video, I'm going to tell you everything about neurosurgeon, like who a neurosurgeon is, what are the eligibility conditions to become a neurosurgeon, how to become a neurosurgeon, job description, responsibilities and career prospects of a neurosurgeon along with his or her average salary and much more. Now, let us start with very basic question, that is, who a neurosurgeon is. Neurology is the branch of medicine that deals with the anatomy, functions and organic disorders of nerves and the nervous system, and physician who specializes in the diagnosis and surgical treatment. Keep this word in mind. Surgical treatment of disorders of the central and peripheral nervous system, including congenital anomalies, trauma, tumors, vascular disorders, infections of the brain or spine, stroke, or degenerative diseases of the spine, is called a neurosurgeon. The word surgical treatment that I told you to keep in mind creates the difference between a neurologist and a neurosurgeon. The two professionals of the same specialty treating the problem with different methods. We will definitely upload a full-fledged video comparing the two. By now, we will concentrate only on neurosurgeon. Now, let me tell you about the required eligibility condition to become a neurosurgeon. If you want to become a neurosurgeon, you have to choose your career path well after your 10th class. The very first qualification that you need to acquire towards your goal is 12th class pass in medical stream, followed by a 5.5 years MBBS degree. So, MBBS degree is the basic eligibility condition to get admission in the specialized medical branch. Besides the basic eligibility conditions, you need to possess a certain set of skills to become a successful neurosurgeon. To handle patients with neurological disorder is really a huge task. And to accomplish it, one requires a different set of skills. If you are looking to adopt this profession, then you must possess an excellent ability to judge human behavior, have a passion to work in trying conditions, have genuine care and concern for their patients, must have intellectual ability to apply the concept of neurological surgeries, should be able to find solutions to problem and deal with people from all walk of life. Besides these mandatory skills, the prospective neurosurgeon must have knowledge of latest medical developments in the field of neurology and be confident, strong decision maker, excellent communicator and emotionally strong and mature enough to be able to work under pressure and have the stamina to work for long hours with strong ethics. Now come to the core question, that is, how can you become a neurosurgeon? To become a neurosurgeon, you need to follow few steps and the very first step is to clear plus two class with physics, chemistry and biology as main subjects. After clearing your 12th or while you are appearing in 12th class exam, you need to clear any of the medical entrance exam so that you could get admission in MBBS course of reputed medical colleges in India. NEET UG, which is conducted by National Testing Agency, is one such medical entrance exam that enables you to get admission in the MBBS course of most of the medical colleges across India. This exam is generally held in the month of May-June every year and is taken by almost all the medical students. After completion of this 4 year of MBBS degree course and 1 year and 6 month long compulsory training, one has to go for specialization. Here you get few options to choose from, and the first option is to appear in the entrance exam for a direct 6 year course in neurosurgery leading to MCH degree offered by autonomous institutes such as AIIMS, NIMHANS, that is National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences, and SCTIMST, that is Sri Chitra Thirunal Institute for Medical Sciences and Technology. Each of these institutes conducts their own entrance exams. And the second option is to appear for NEET PG entrance exam and secure a position in a 3 year general surgery training program leading to MS degree. Then, one has to appear in the NEET SS, that is, Super Speciality Entrance Exam, to secure a training position in the 3-year neurosurgery course leading to MCH degree. In case you are not able to secure a good rank in the NEET SS exam, you can also undergo neurosurgery training from private hospitals with DNB, that is Diplomate of National Board Accreditation. One has to qualify the DNB CET, that is Centralized Entrance Test SS exam, conducted by the National Board of Examinations, and thereafter get enrolled with an accredited private teaching institute and hospital for training. On completion of the 3-year training program, one will be awarded the DNB degree in neurosurgery. The government has announced that MCH and DNB degrees will be treated at par while applying for jobs. So guys, you can adopt any of the 3 ways to reach to your goal as per your liking and abilities. Now let me tell you about the job profile, or you can say the responsibilities of a neurosurgeon. The basic responsibilities of a neurosurgeon is to examine and diagnose disorders of or injuries to the nervous system and perform surgeries on the brain, spinal cord and peripheral nerves to treat these conditions. He or she is the one who oversee and coordinate a team of surgeons and nurses to perform these surgeries to remove tumors, relieve chronic pain and treat wounds, vascular disorders and diseases. Neurosurgeon's job profile includes ordering, performing and interpreting results of diagnostic tests such as MRIs, PET scans and CT scans, assessing and diagnosing patients, prescribing treatments and monitoring the patient's progress, meeting with families of patients in surgery and keeping them updated, handling unscheduled emergency surgeries, working with psychiatrist, therapist and neurologist and consulting with other departments, performing basic administrative and business tasks such as keeping record, writing prescription and filling out paperwork. Besides these tasks, a neurosurgeon is also supposed to keep up with new discoveries and attending academic conferences. Now, you would like to know about some of the top medical institutes who offer this specialization in neurosurgery. There are numerous government and private PG medical colleges that are providing specialization in neurology. However, some of the best medical colleges that you can think of getting admission are All Indian Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi, National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences, Sri Chitra Tirunal Institute for Medical Sciences and Technology, Christian Medical College, Vellore, Armed Forces Medical College, Pune, JIPMER College, Puducherry, and Maulana Azad Medical College, New Delhi. In fact, there are many more medical institutes providing this course. You can visit our website targetstudy.com and look for the other institutes in your state or area providing MCH neurosurgery course. Now you would like to know about the career prospects and job opportunities for neurosurgeons. Unfortunate but a reality that the career prospect for neurosurgeon appears bright due to rapid increase in patients inflicted with disorders and injuries related to the nervous system. Qualified neurosurgeon can get placed in the neurosurgery department of reputed hospitals like AIIMS, PGI and Max, etc. They can also find employment with medical organization associated with police, paramilitary and defense forces and other government organization where there is a need of such professionals. Neurosurgeon having more enterprising skills can also open their own clinic and make fortune for themselves. Those who are interested in academics can also opt for teaching jobs in different medical schools and colleges and teach their students basic techniques and treatments related to neurological disorders. Research is the another option for the genius in the field. Now you would like to know about the salaries and pay packages of a neurosurgeon. Neurosurgeons are some of those medical specialists that are highly regarded and monetarily compensated according to the heart specialty they have chosen. Their salaries largely depend upon the experience and the expertise they have attained. However, the average salary that a fresh neurosurgeon can expect to get can be anything between ₹75,000 to ₹1 lakh per month, depending upon the healthcare center one has joined. However, experienced neurosurgeon engaged in the corporate sector can expect anything between ₹1,50,000 to ₹2 lakh per month. Whereas, In government sector, the salaries are paid according to the pay scale prevalent in a particular state or hospital. Although the enhanced salary in government sector may be little less than the private sector, but government neurosurgeons are also entitled to government accommodation and other perks as admissible. Neurosurgeon with an excellent track record running their own clinic has the ability to earn much more. That's all from this video, guys. I hope you find this video informative. For more such videos, subscribe Target Study YouTube channel, and to get regular notification, hit the bell icon. Thank you for watching.